So in this video, we will be comparing the ZCam E2 F6 to the Arri Alexa Classic. Can a 10-year-old dinosaur beat the ZCam's newest cinema camera? Now, just a disclaimer, like always, I will not be doing scientific controlled tests since it's hard to judge cameras in perfectly lit conditions. So instead, majority of the test shots I did were grab and go shots in the middle of the day when shooting conditions were not ideal whatsoever. So let's begin with what features the ZCam F6 beats the Arri Alexa in. First off is size and weight. The ZCam is so small considering what it can do. I weighed my Arri Alexa setup and it was 23.2 pounds, and that's with a small contact size lens, guys. So size and weight goes to ZCam F6 easily. Now next up, recording options. The ZCam F6 has a crap ton of recording options built in from H.264, ProRes, Z-RAW, and additionally, if you have an Atomos recorder now, you can also record in ProRes RAW. The Arri Alexa has ProRes only. I had to get an external recorder, the Odyssey 7Q, for it to record 2.8K RAW. Which leads us to the next topic of resolutions. The F6 can shoot OpenGate 6K all the way down to 1080p. It's insane how much variety the F6 has when it comes to resolutions. Granted, as you all know, resolution isn't really that important to me. That's why I have a 2.8K Arri Alexa. But if you like options, resolution options, go for the F6. Next up is slow motion. The ZCam F6 is loaded with high frame rate options from maximum quality of 4K 60 frames per second in Z-RAW, but slower options are available for lower resolutions. You guys already know how I feel about Arri Alexa Classic's slow motion capabilities, so yeah, F6 will take slow motion or high frame rates. Next up is low light capability shooting. Maximum ISO you can shoot with the Arri Alexa is 3200. On the other hand, I was able to get decent footage from the F6 at ISO 5000. ZCam F6 is dual native ISO, so this makes sense. Next up are extra features. The F6 comes with a crap ton of useful features. Features such as anamorphic D-squeeze, remote control with live view using your iPhone, built-in microphone, and more. ZCam packed the F6 with so much stuff, it's crazy. I can't go over everything they put in this camera. So the last thing the F6 beats the Arri Alexa in is the price point. Right now, the F6 is priced at $3,995 body only. Even with accessories added like an Atomos recorder, the F6 will still be cheaper than the 10-year-old Arri Alexa as of right now, 2020 in July. Now that we talked about what the ZCam was better at, it's time to talk about what features I preferred on the Arri Alexa EV. So first things first is the image quality and color science. Granted, any decent colorist can make any footage look as good as the Alexa, right? I absolutely love how easy it is to get amazing shots with the Arri Alexa though. I honestly thought it was something made up by fanboys, but I'm telling you right now, once you use an Arri Alexa and color correct it in post, it is very hard to look elsewhere. There's just a certain grit, look, texture to it that it's hard to explain. But is it worth the price? You have to ask yourself that. Now, the next thing I like about the Arri Alexa is its over and under exposure recovery. The F6 was not able to recover as much as the Arri Alexa in overexposure. However, I am not sure if this is a software limitation or a camera limitation, but time will tell. Underexposure wise, the Arri Alexa renders some of the greatest, darkest part of the image I have ever seen. Most camera I have used in the past, I am scared to go dark, but not the Arri Alexa. You have a decent amount of leeway in the shadows with this camera. So what does this really mean by the Arri Alexa having better overexposure and underexposure? So the ZCam recovery is not bad, but basically what you need to watch out for is overexposing your shots and underexposing your shots. If you know how to expose properly in camera, you will not have a problem with the ZCam F6. I don't want to just take a jab at it, but what I'm trying to say is with the Arri Alexa, you kind of have a lot more leeway if you jacked up a scene or something like that, or like a wedding, or somehow the sun just came out and all of a sudden everything is blown out because you're outdoors and the sun came out. With the Arri Alexa, you're going to be able to adjust that in post-production. In F6, you just have to be careful. You have to be ready. You have to be prepared because it is harder to get details back. Now, the last thing the Arri Alexa has over the F6 right now is codec support, Arri RAW. As of right now, July 2020, for you to process Z-RAW on the Z-Cam, you have to use their software or download the Adobe Premiere plugin. I gotta say, it's been 7 years since I've used Premiere. I've been using Resolve since, my God, what happened to Premiere? I have a GTX 1080 Ti, which is the recommended graphics card for the Z-RAW plugin for Premiere, and it is absolutely horse dookie butt. It's not working properly. I can't get proper playback. The footage go offline randomly, so it is just not ready. What I'm trying to say is right now I can drop my Arri RAW file in DaVinci Resolve and it would work beautifully. Z-Cam, if you're listening, I'm trying to tell you right now, you need to sort this out. Your Z-RAW is really good, but it's getting crippled by the lack of NLE support. You have worked so hard thus far. Please work something out with Blackmagic Design so they can support your Z-RAW. So let's talk about the verdict. If you absolutely want the best image possible in a camera and you are torn between these two cameras and have the money for it and have the tripod for it, go for the Arri Alexa. However, if you're a decent colorist or other people work on your stuff, buy the Z-Cam. But if you can wait, the newly released Canon R5 is just right around the corner and it's around the same price of the Z Cam. It shoots 8K RAW in DaVinci, already released a version that supports Canon R5 RAW footage, which is exactly my point. Now, I know everyone's freaking out about the overheating problem, but I want to see that for myself. I know a lot of YouTubers, they just test the camera out and then complain about it. Like always, guys, don't forget to download the files in the comments below. If you guys have any questions, let me know, and I will see you guys later.